This is Blood and Guts. Pretty awesome game. It's also one of those games that is a collection of mini games. So I think this video is going to be a little longer one. Sorry about that. Pretty nice loading screen. Ancient Barbarian Games is a good description of the collection of mini games. And here we go. We'll go with compete instead of practice. Got a selection of four different characters. There is no difference in the game, but we'll just go with the dog. At this point, it shows like you are selecting the character for the second player, but if you choose the same character again, that will start a one-player game. And the first event is Tug of War. Your job is to pull the computer to the brink. Which isn't going that well. Come on, come on, you can do it. No, you can't. Yeah, I don't know. Got some trouble controlling that, but you saw how the game is, even if I lost. And it's a one-off. Some of the events are one-off, and some of them you have to win several. And the next event is Tower Jump. Aim of the game is to jump far and land face first. Not face first, like you have to land head down. Couldn't do it. Let's try again. No way. And you got only three tries. And that's it. Stupid, I couldn't make it. The next event is Rock Roller. You have to push the rock up the hill. You wiggle the joystick until you are agreed, and then you push the button and you can take a step. Roll it up and push button, and there you go. Ha ha. You have to win twice to win this event. So let's do it again. And it's hard work. And there it goes again. I win. Still, third time? No bloody way. Ah, that's hard work. But I win again. And the next event is beer drinking. You bring the beer up to filter your mouth. Bring the beer down and wiggle sideways to swallow. And more beer. And you have to be careful that you don't spill it. It's an even competition. Oh, I won. That was close. And if you spew, The player will actually curse. I will show you this one. Fill it two up. Squoosh. And it says, damn, and you lose the... lose the round. Let's do it. Drinking beer has never been this hard work. The next event is called Human Hit, and you got four targets which you have to hit each three times as quickly as possible. I remember when I was playing this as a kid, I used to amuse myself by throwing the rocks at his face, even if I got the target already. To the right of my time, you can see the time that the computer seemingly has already done, which we don't see. Not in this event. Got it. I win! On to the next event. Okay, next event is pole fight, where you have to knock your opponent down from the log. Do something, you stupid. Do something. Do something. Hit him. Hit him. There you go. Bye-bye. And one try is enough. In this point, you have to remember to switch the... switch the side of the floppy, because this copy is a little bit corrupted, so if I didn't change it at this point, the game would have crashed, but I did turn it, so on to the next event. This event is one of my all-time favorites. It's cat throwing. You press the button to start to accelerate and let the player spin up and release the cat. 54, that's a really long throw. You got three tries to try to beat the computer. If you wait too long, the guy will get tired and stop, so you lose a try. Oh, that was a good one. Ho-ho-ho! With the last one, I'll show you what happens if you release the cat at the wrong time. It's a very satisfying sound effect for it. Splat. On to the next event. Next event is Mountain Walk, where you just have to walk to the middle of the rope. I just fell. Side to side seems to control your balance, but how do you actually walk? Even the... oh, that was just completely wrong. Anyway, I just lost. What a surprise. On to the next event. Oh, still one. Stay up there. Maybe you push up to walk forward, or you press the fire button to walk. I think that's it. Walk, you muppet. I know you can do it. I'm the one on the left, if you didn't notice. Less time you spend fidgeting around, the more distance you do. It's not easy. But at least I'm not falling yet. But I think he will beat me to it easily. Oh no! Splat, 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 splat. I like how he bounces around. Next event. And in this event, you throw an axe and try to hit the guy. You can either jump or dodge, and that's all. And you do it until one of you screw up and get hit by an axe. Oh, it was fast. But so was I. Ooh, too bad. One try and it's over. Then again, if you get hit by an axe, you probably don't get a second try. And this is the last event. It's an arm wreck, where you just wiggle left and right to bring the enemy's arm down to the table. And there will be a bird that marks who's the loser. That's some precise bombing. Next round. Splat. I guess that's the reason why they shaved their heads for this event. Not sure if there's a third one. Yes, there is. Doing well in these brute force events. And next to the high score, or the punishment table, punishment screen. And at the end, oh, it's a draw. That's the first time I got that one. At the end, the barbarian that loses will get what he deserves. So in this case, Loser Hawk, a very gruesome way to finish up the game. A bit like Commando Libya with the guillotine. Bye bye. No blood, how sad. Turn the disc around to load the main screen again. And here we go, back to the main screen. So that's Blood and Guts for Commodore 64. Bloody good game, especially against a friend. Thanks for watching.